The Cranberries, formerly known as cranberry sauce, are known as the most commercially successful band of the 90s. They were originally just a band started by two brothers. The key to their success? It may just be due to their lead singer Dolores or the inclusion of their politically controversial lyrics. Whatever may be the case, the Cranberries sold 50 million albums worldwide as of 2019 and released 8 studio albums and 23 singles. The Cranberries were formed in Limerick, Ireland in 1990 and are considered to be an alternative rock band with inspirations from Irish folk music. Mike and Noel Hogan originally formed the band with Niall Quinn as the lead singer. The band members include Dolores O'Riordan, Noel Hogan, Fergal Lawler, Mike Hogan, and Niall Quinn. However, after Quinn left the band, they begin looking for a new member. Dolores auditioned for the spot. She stated, "The songs were not my taste, but I saw the potential in the playing. It was easy for me because no matter what their first impressions were, I knew the minute I opened my mouth that they were going to be impressed." When Dolores auditioned, they were all unsure of each other. She was a rural girl among city boys, and initially she was as quiet as a mouse, as Noel recalls. When they heard Dolores sing, they were immediately impressed. Dolores became the frontwoman for the band and was an incredible musician. She grew up singing in her church and school choir. Dolores learned classical piano in her church choir, and at the age of 17, she also taught herself guitar. Additionally, Noel and Dolores worked together as songwriters, but from the beginning, they never wrote in the same room together. They would create the guitar parts on the cassette and then go to their own spaces to write. Their demos that they created earned attention from both the UK press and the record companies, and then there was a bidding war over the albums that they made. The group signed with Island and went to produce their first single, Uncertain. They then released their hit single, Dream.
Salvation was the lead single in the Cranberries' third studio album, To the Faithful Departed. Released on April 8, 1996, it quickly reached number one on US billboards for 4 consecutive weeks. The song focused on drug abuse and warns people to avoid falling down the slippery slope of addiction. The lyrics read, "To all those people doing lines, don't do it, don't do it. And to all the kids with heroin eyes, don't do it, don't do it." They combat doing drugs by saying, "Inject your soul with liberty. It's not what it seems, and that salvation is free." The media and other critics thought this song was too preachy for a rock song. Dolores O'Riordan explained that it was more about avoiding being controlled by anything more than a song that is just anti-drug. She says that reality will always be reality, no matter if you are on drugs or not. This song directly relates to the drug pandemic in the UK at this time.
In the late 1960s to the late 1980s, there was a conflict in Northern Ireland between the Protestant Unionists and the Roman Catholic Nationalists. The Unionists wanted Northern Ireland to stay a part of the United Kingdom, while the Nationalists wanted it to become a part of the Republic of Ireland. This conflict stems back centuries ago when British landlords were sent to Ireland and granted land there. From that, much of the Irish people didn't appreciate Britain at all, which is shown throughout the time period of the Troubles. During the time, the Cranberries were starting to gain popularity, and the conflict had started getting inherently more and more violent. In March of 1993, the Irish Republican Army hid 2 bombs and trash cans on a busy shopping street in the Cheshire town of Warrington and then detonated them. 3-year-old Jonathan Ball was killed immediately, and 12-year-old Tim Perry died 5 days later in the hospital due to the bomb. Dolores was deeply affected during the time, which is apparent during her writing of the song Zombie, as well as several interviews afterwards. She told Vox magazine in 1994, "I remember seeing one of the mothers on television, just devastated. I felt so sad for her that she carried him for 9 months, been through all the morning sickness, the whole thing, and then some prick, some airhead, who thought he was making a point, did that," in reference to the Warrington Street bombing. So she wrote Zombie as a primary response to that bombing, and then also made a call out to previous political wars in history. Let's take a look at it right now. Opening distorted electric guitar and much heavier and somber drums showed that this song would not be like any of their previous songs in their first album. opening line of the song, "Another head hangs lowly, child is slowly taken," lives up to the somber tone notes of an instrumental and draws attention to the innocent lives taken during war, in a direct reference to Tim Perry, who suffered in a hospital bed for 5 days before passing away because of the Warrington bomb. And then the next line goes, "And the violence caused such silence, who are we mistaken?" which showcases the oppressive atmosphere and the mass confusion and helplessness that such wars have caused that no one wanted to speak out against. Then the chorus says, "But you see, it's not me, it's not my family," which showcases her distance to the conflict, but still her affliction to it as well. This line was discussed also during her Vox interview, where she said, "The IRA are not me, I'm not the IRA. The Cranberries are not IRA, my family are not. The IRA is not IRA, just some idiots living in the past, living for a fallen dream. Dolores and the Cranberries don't care what religion anyone was, just the fact that innocent people were being harmed, which shouldn't be happening in any situation." The rest of the chorus goes on to say, in your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their bombs and their guns. With the emphasis repetition of in your head is a call to people to recognize that violence that happens externally will also be present in your head, in your emotions, and in your thoughts. The repeated methodologies of the war also emphasize the fact that the war is happening and it cannot be ignored. All of these tanks and these bombs and guns will be exploding and causing mass chaos, so it's not something that can be taken lightly. Then the keynote verse of the song repeats, "What's in your head, zombie, zombie, zombie." This is a call to action to listeners to reflect on your thoughts and attitudes as these political conflicts have carried out, then calls all the listeners to realize that you are a zombie to the violence, mindless and no thought, already dead, and will contribute to the never-ending cycle. The rest of the song goes on to continue the same verses and choruses with a reference to another political conflict in 1916. The continued repetition shows that it's all just been endless and endless cycle, and Dolores is calling for some kind of change to the system to ensure this doesn't keep happening. She's trying to call towards the local citizens to go to their governments and hopefully find some way to end this political conflict.
Another one of their top songs was Linger. Guitarist Noel Hogan wrote this song before Dolores became a part of the band. Dolores took the lyrics and turned them into a story about her first boyfriend, a soldier that she was once in love with. She described it as a love song in which she was mistreated but still wanted to pursue something with him. This song is an example of how the Cranberries turned away from conservative, traditional British songs and started writing lyrics about topics that were more controversial, as demonstrated in this song, singing about boys.
The Cranberries confirmed in September of 2018 that they would not continue as a band after the death of their lead singer, Dolores O'Riordan, from alcohol poisoning that same year. The band said that they would disband after the final album, In the End, was released in April of 2019. The Cranberries rank as one of the best-selling alternative acts of the 1990s, having sold nearly 50 million albums worldwide as of 2019. In 1998, the Cranberries were invited to perform at the Nobel Peace Prize ceremony among the political leaders that brought peaceful resolution to Ireland's conflict. The troubles in Ireland came to an end earlier that year, but the band's hit song, Zombies, legacy lives on as a protest against violence. Even today, the song's message remains relevant as police brutality and abuse of power comes at the expense of young lives. Both Generation X and Generation Z share the song's defiant attitude and eagerness to break free from old practices in their fight for social justice through the Black Lives Matter and LGBTQ rights movements. With the growth of the Black Lives Matter movement and LGBT rights movement, the Cranberries have come back into popularity. As mentioned previously, the band's lyrics are viewed as a way to commit to peaceful resolutions in difficult times. Popping up in popular social media apps such as TikTok, songs such as Zombie and Linger by the Cranberries can be found being sung in protest or support of popular political movements, continuing the legacy of the band and its association with political activism within a young generation.